was in the neuro ICU as part of one of my rotations, and we had a patient come in with a ruptured brain aneurysm. And he went to the OR, got his aneurysm clipped, and he came back, and the next day he was looking great. He was talking, he was interactive. What happened though is that over the course of about a week, he became more sleepy, he stopped talking, and he stopped being able to move his arms and his legs. And we did everything that we could clinically. We just didn't understand what fundamentally was happening. And so I have a PhD, and I was interested in doing research. As I was developing research, as I was getting better at asking the right questions, the Brain Aneurysm Foundation funding came at a critical moment for me, because you know, there isn't actually specific funding for brain aneurysm research. What we're trying to do is we're trying to test whether a phenomenon called cortical spreading depolarization is responsible for this progressive brain injury. And a cortical spreading depression, or cortical spreading depolarization, is a spreading wave of increased brain activity accompanied by decreased blood flow to the brain. And this leads to an energy mismatch. And we think that this energy mismatch is what is causing this brain injury, this brain damage. And so we have developed a model where we can cause these cortical spreading depolarizations non-invasively and test if indeed these cortical spreading depolarizations cause further brain injury. And so what we do for this is we inject blood into mice to simulate a ruptured brain aneurysm. And then after that, we have readouts to see how the mice are doing. So behavioral tests, mazes that we have the mice go through to see how they do after the spreading depolarization. And then we have another readout, which is a readout that looks at how different parts of the brain connect to each other. And so we're testing whether or not spreading depolarizations also cause problems with how different parts of the brain connect to each other, and if that leads to problems in their behavior and problems with performance. A lot of my inspiration comes from trying to optimize, trying to improve that quality of life. You know, what can we do while patients are in the hospital to give them the best chance of getting back to normal as possible? And so trying to prevent this brain injury, trying to prevent these long-term cognitive outcomes, even in people who don't have this progressive brain injury. Those are the questions that are driving what we do in the lab.